This video is going to take you through how to write molecular ionic and net ionic equations from formulas. If you click the link under the YouTube video, it'll take you to the website. It's easier to follow on there. The rules are in a printable PDF form, so you can follow along much easier. So what you're going to do is step one, you're going to write on the molecular line. You're going to write your formulas for your two reactants that you were given. Step two, you're going to write the names of the reactants, which are potassium sulfate and barium chloride. Step three, you're going to write the names of the products. So what you do is you just take potassium and you switch last names. So potassium instead of sulfate is now potassium chloride, and barium instead of barium gets sulfate's last name. What you're going to do is you're going to check the solubility of the products. This is an important step because if they're both aqueous, there's no reaction, and you got to stop doing all this because you're wasting time. So what you're going to notice here, potassium chloride, well, potassium is in group one, and that's always aqueous because it's always soluble. Barium sulfate, well, sulfates are generally aqueous or soluble, except with barium, and you have a solid right there, which means there's a reaction and you're free to proceed. So, since it's a solid, what you're going to do is you're going to jump down to line three, and we're going to write the ions involved in this reaction. So since we have potassium sulfate, potassium's ion is K+, and sulfate's ion is SO4 2-. Ignore the numbers there for now. Barium is Ba2+, and chloride is Cl-. You put your arrow there. Now that we have our four ions, we can do our formulas. Well, this formula is already done, so plus 1 and minus 2, there's our ratio, K2SO4, same thing with barium chloride. What we can do now is use these ions to figure out our products. Well, potassium chloride, take potassium at plus 1 and chloride at minus 1, and you write KCl, there's our ratio, 1:1. For barium sulfate, barium's plus 2, sulfate's minus 2. Well, that's also a 1:1 ratio. What we get to do now is you get to check your solubility rules, since these were already told that we're aqueous, and we've already done the solubilities of our two products. We don't have to go much further than that, we just bring them down. Now what we're going to do is we're going to bring down our solids, so BaSO4 solid gets to be brought down to not only the ionic, but to the net ionic. And now the KCl gets to be brought down, but it has to be brought down as ions because it's aqueous. So, look over here, K was K plus, Cl is Cl minus, and that part's done. Now we have to put in our phases for all of the ions, which are aqueous. Now that that's done, and both reactions are almost complete, we get to balance it. So we're going to go back up to the molecular, two potassiums, one potassium. So we put a 2 in front. Now we have two Cls, that's fine. One barium, sulfates, one sulfate, it's balanced. Now what we have to do is we have to break up the molecular into the ions below. So how many potassium ions are in K2SO4? There's two of them. So we're going to put a 2 in front of the potassium. There's one sulfate, there's one barium ion, there's two Cls, so we put a 2 in front. There's two KCls, or two moles of KCls, so you put 2s in front of both of them. It's kind of like a pair of shoes. You have two left shoes, two right shoes. Barium sulfate, that stays the same. You just need the coefficient that's in front of it, which is 1. The net ionic, you need to get rid of your spectators. Spectators occur on both sides of the reaction. They don't change, so potassium doesn't change. That's a spectator, and Cl minus, the chloride ion, does not change. So everything left over is part of the net ionic. So you have your barium ion and your sulfate ion. These are both aqueous because they're ions. And what you're going to notice is the two ions that are left over should be the ions that make up the solid. And right there, that's how you write your molecular ionic and net ionic equation for potassium sulfate reacting with barium chloride.